Hi, my name is Danielle Dietz-Livolsi, and I am the founder and CEO of the Nutso brand. It's a seven nut and seed butter. Basically, we take seven nuts and seeds, we grind it into this yummy butter, and you can put it and eat it on anything. So I wanted to tell you briefly how I started my company. I started it 8 years ago, but I really started it quite a while ago because it was after my husband and I adopted our first son from the Ukraine. Greg was 3.5 years old when we adopted him. I got him home. He was super vitamin deficient. He was actually in the 5th percentile on height and weight. And unfortunately, he didn't like to eat. So it was really a struggle to find things he would eat. And then he had this issue that we didn't really understand at first, but he would just chew and chew and chew and actually not be able to swallow. So it really made it a challenge with any animal protein or any sort of textures. So one of the things I was really racking my brain about was to create a vegan source of protein. And I came up with this idea one day. I love nut butters. And as a child, I love peanut butter. So I knew enough that if I took peanuts, which are really a legume, plus nuts and seeds, I could make a complete protein. I got out my food processor, I threw in a bunch of nuts and seeds. I didn't just want almonds because I wanted a wide variety of nuts and seeds, because all nuts and seeds have different vitamins and minerals that they're known for. And then I added some flaxseed oil for the omega-3s, whipped it up. I chose a banana because he liked bananas at the time, and I put some on top and he ate it. So fast forward 2008, I launched my own business because there was no other multi-nut butters out there. We were the original one. And of course, I started with Peanut Pro because that was Greg's. A year and a half later, I came out with the Power Fuel, which is a non-peanut version. And this new little guy to the family is called the Paleo Power Fuel. And this is amazing. So if you love chocolate, again, we don't add any sugar, so super healthy nut butter. And then the chocolate comes from Eating Evolved, which is a paleo chocolate. It's so yummy. Only 2 grams of sugar and 2 tablespoons of the Paleo Chocolate Power Fuel. Again, upside down so that the oils will naturally separate. It's kind of a little trick. You just obviously flip it over, open it up, stir it really well, and you don't get all those crazy oils all over your countertop. It just makes it easier, no mess. So that's it behind Nutso. I'm super excited for this whole interview, and I just wanted to highlight 5 things that I wish I would have known or somebody would have told me before I became a CEO of my company. And my favorite one that I listed was regarding really following your gut and to never be talked into any big decision. Because I think as CEOs, we already kind of have that sixth sense and intuition just to be a CEO and start your own business. And sometimes we forget, or we think that, you know, we might just be being scared or fearful, but I think you can really detect when it's your sixth sense saying, no, 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 red lights flashing, like you just, no way, it doesn't feel right. So an example of that that I had, and I've had a lot of different examples of a lot of different things, but this one in particular was our first round of funding. So my husband and I had bootstrapped it up until 2014, and then we really needed some cash for cash flow and to grow. And so we started off with friends and family, and that was amazing, but we still needed to close out the round, so we had to go more publicly. And there was a gentleman that was super excited about the brand, and he was great, but then there was this gatekeeper. And this guy was just not somebody that resonated well with me and my style. He was very micromanaging. He put me on tests. I'm trying to run my own business. I have like no employees, and he's trying to run me through a bunch of tests, like how long it took me to email him back. And then he would ask me a bunch of questions to see if I would really answer them about my business. And it was just so time consuming. And all I kept thinking is, oh my gosh, I don't think I could like handle him on a full-time basis. Like, he wasn't going to be somebody that it was the once-a-week phone call, you know? Push came to shove. We were almost going to, like, we had really no other options at the time, and we were going to sign on the dotted line, and I just said, like, at the last day, I was like, I can't do this. Like, everything in me is telling me not to do it, and I realized, like, this could mean I have to close my doors if I don't have enough money, but I just really can't do it. So we didn't do the deal, and a month and a half later, I signed a deal with an investor that was just such a better fit. So my point is, do not, you know, go with some decision that's not your gut. Like, if your gut is screaming at you, do not do it. And then lastly, I want to tell you about one other thing that's I'm super passionate about. So not only is Nutso a lifestyle brand and a healthy snack brand, but we have a nonprofit that my husband and I started at the same time that I launched Nutso, and it's called Project Left Behind, and it was started because of our two sons that we did adopt. I have a really strong passion to help other children out there that are in need of education and food, and they are neglected and sometimes orphaned children throughout the world. So we start our own nonprofit, and the two reasons that our nonprofit is different is, number one, any proceeds that are donated from Nutso or privately from private donors go 100% to the children, which means that there's no overhead, there's no airplane tickets bought from donations, nothing like that. And then number two is that we vet out all of the nonprofits and the children homes that are in other countries, because we want to make sure that obviously the money's going there. Luckily, I'm the one that usually gets to go vet them out, and I love that. We work at the facilities and donate our time. Obviously, we give them money mostly for education and food and shelter. And the last thing that I love about it is that we get to not only work there, but we usually do some sort of a meal, and I'm a big foodie, so I love to, you know, do a big meal with the kids, and they love it, and it's just super awesome. So, go Nutso, go Project Left Behind, and thanks for listening. Bye-bye.